because this video has failed already, I will show you from the start what we're going to accomplish, so you won't waste your time to go any further. So, we'll make a virtual reality scene on Sumerian, with a very basic state machine and speech from Polly. But most importantly, this is a quick guide how to set the permissions from Amazon console. Anyway, it will be exactly this.
Hello, how are you? Did you know that Ubuntu sucks?
Okay, I will begin totally from scratch and I will describe the full process step by step. So, I have a tab on Sumerian homepage, and I have one more on Amazon console that later I'm going to create the permissions and policies. So Sumerian app, and create a new scene. And Amazon already proposes to name it to Ubuntu Sucks. That's the real anime intelligence. Back to reality, we get a warning that Chrome and Linux doesn't support augmented reality devices. That's not really an issue for creating our scene, but it means we can't actually see it if we had a VR headset. Anyway, the first thing we want is to create a Cognito ID. So we go to Amazon console, then we choose Cognito service, and then manage identity pools. Next we want to create a new identity pool, and we're going to give it the same name as our project. Simply and plain, Ubuntu sucks. Then we will enable unauthenticated identities, and allow basic flow. I don't want to explain all those now, so just create pool. On this page Amazon has created two roles. One is for authenticated identities, and the other is for the unauthenticated, which is what we are going to use later for setting Poly services. And allow. Here we can see already the ID, but let me do it from start because the navigation may get tricky. Basically I'm gonna close this tab. So Cognito again, and manage identity pools. Now we see the Ubuntu sucks pool. Click on that, and then edit identity pool on top right. Which is easy to find because in GNOME we are used to such craps. And that's our Cognito ID, that we need to copy and paste it back to Sumerian. Time to full screen this, and work a bit inside. First I will add a new entity on the scene and I will pick a quad object to make kinda a floor. I'm going to speed this up because there is nothing exciting to see. Basically I just add a name, set dimensions to 6, rotate to minus 90 degrees and adding a texture. Then I'm going to import a character from Assets panel, and we can also import FBX models from Blender, assuming we have proper rigging. On bottom left we have our Assets panel, that is grouped to package containers. The default package is basically whatever we add in our scene, like this Ubuntu texture. Speaking of which, it's better to use JPG images and not PNG with transparency, because 3D engines suffer with alpha channels. And meanwhile I dragged the model into the scene already, but Sumerian editor is extremely slow and I'm cutting the loading times. Okay, video main event. When we select the model we have a speech entity. First I will select Amy voice and set to neural engine. The 3D option is for setting the sound volume depending the distance we are, since that's augment reality. Next step is to actually create the audio file. So we click on add a speech file, and we get Sumerian script editor. Although I'm not using SSML tags, that's an SSML format. And I'm going to type the text you listened in the beginning. And save. Close this. And now if we try to play the speech we created, it just won't happen. If we open Chrome console, we will see a 403 error that forbids to load speech resources. That's because we need to assign additional permissions to our identity role. Back to console and we pick the identity and access management service. From there, we go to roles, and we want the Ubuntu sucks unauthenticated role. Then we want to attach speech permissions policies. Search for Poly, and select full access. Not sure why I selected the read-only two, but whatever. Attach policy and we are done. Back to Sumerian now. So, try again to play the audio, and this time? Poof, crap. It won't play. Okay, this guide failed. Goodbye without any dignity. Ha, Baby Woke never fails. Just refresh the browser, and voila!
Hello, how are you? Did you know that Ubuntu sucks?
I'm fine, and I know. Okay, Now that this unexpectedly worked, let's go on with some of Sumerian's state machine engine. Just to make it clear, this guide was all about setting the speech because Amazon console is a mess. I'm not going to make a Sumerian guide, so consider this like an extra content. So, I added a sphere on the scene, and let me speed up the embarrassing moment I'm trying to resize it and positioning it. But on my defense and as a warning too, Sumerian editor really sucks. It is not exactly like working on Blender. That, by the way, later I'm going to open and import this scene. Alright, now we're done with the visuals, we will create a new component and we will select a state machine. With him, we open the state machine editor, and next we want to add a behavior. Behaviors is a set of states, and each state executes a set of actions. The logic is the same as game engines, for example Unity. But Sumerian is so much better and I will tell you my master plan on the end video. Anyway, in our initial state we set a wait action, and we are telling it to wait for 2 seconds before the next step. So, for next step, we will add a new state, and we will again add a new action. In this case I will select a tween move. I go a bit fast maybe, but all those are pretty easy so I'm just trying to save time. On tween properties, I will set 3 units on X axis. Basically since floor is 6 units the sphere will move to the left edge. Oh, before anything else, I will rename this behavior to ball animation, just to keep everything clean and tidy. Then, I will connect the first state to second. So now if we play the scene, the ball will wait for 2 seconds, and then it will go from here to there. Okay, play. So the ball will move according to the plan, but it will stay there without having a next state, which means this is not really a state machine. Before I fix this, let me quickly duplicate the tween states just to visualize Sumerian interface a bit better. Play this again, and the ball will go on left edge, and then it will go on right edge, and then it will return on initial state, and stop. If we want to loop the machinery, we can? Oops, second to pause the scene first. So we can connect the last state to the initial state. So that is going to always loop. So let's play the scene again. And this time it will always continue to work, doing a 2 seconds pause on initial. And watch how Sumerian highlights each active state, which is why I added the multiple states, because that's again not real automation. Meanwhile I just realized we don't have speech, which was the original purpose of this video. And to be honest, I didn't prepare anything. I just open Sumerian and start recording without any plan, without any plot, without any direction. So, let's add some speech and speech gestures. With Fiona selected, we will add a state machine component the same way we did with the sphere before. And again we will create a new behavior. The difference is that this time on the initial state we need to load the Amazon Web Services SDK, so we can access Poly service. So add action, and SDK ready. Oh, and also? That means we are charged twice, both for Sumerian and Poly services. Sneaky Amazon? Anyway, one more state to Fiona's behavior, and we will just add a start speech action. On a side note, I had started working with Sumerian last November, and then I quit it, but they have improved lots of things since then. Okay, just putting a meaningful name on the behavior, and then we need to connect the two states. Next we will select our speech file that we had created like 10 minutes ago, and finally play the scene.
Hello, how are you? Did you know that Ubuntu sucks?
To make Fiona's behavior more natural we can add some speech gestures, but before, I want to show you something I forgot. So back to ball behavior, and on initial state we have a wait action. However, the goal of Amazon Sumerian is the interacting augment reality. So we can remove the wait action and instead we can add a key press action. In fact we can even add voice commands. In fact, we can do much more than that. Anyway, now the ball machinery will start after we press A, and it will always stop on initial state till we press it again. I will skip the scene and revert back to wait. Okay, back to Fiona to add some speech gestures. With J, we open the text editor. This file is actually SSML, so at the very minimum we need the speak tags. Just in case you don't know, SSML stands for Speech Synthesis Markup Language, and while it is supposed to be a standard, Amazon Poly or Google WaveNet and others have some special tags. Anyway, to easily create some speech gestures we can add a gesture map. This JSON is self-explained, and each word triggers a gesture. For example, under defense value I can add Ubuntu word, so every time Fiona says Ubuntu it will trigger the defense gesture. Save this file always, and it is so very annoying it can't autosave. Now, to actually apply the gestures we need to click on auto generate button, that will edit our SSML file. Before I run the scene, let me open it once more time to see what Sumerian actually did. So it added these gesture marks just before any triggered word. But I'm going to remove everything and only leave the defense gesture. Okay, so right before Fiona says Ubuntu sucks, she will go on defense stance, in case Alan Pope is around and suspend her from Amazon. And play the scene. Actually, let me close the irrelevant UIs first, to admire better Fiona's defense mode against Ubuntu. Okay, and now play, from a perfect angle.
Hello, how are you? Did you know that Ubuntu sucks?
So that move she did was the speech gesture, and it might wasn't the cutest move ever, but we can import our own models and animations. Oh, and the best part is totally the perfect lip syncing. Another thing is that we can now publish the scene. So from top right we have a publish menu, and it will just publish to a public link without needing any authentication. Obviously we can embed the scene to our native applications, and it has so great potential to create some really cool apps. But it has a great cost too, which is why we almost never see community apps using cloud services.
Hello, how are you? Did you know that Ubuntu sucks?
And again, this is augmented reality technology, so it can add some real environment objects to our scene. And hopefully by end year I will do lots of virtual reality on this channel. It was supposed to happen sooner, but Corona moved everything back for me. To finish this video, some more things is that we have a scene stats panel that displays our object stats together with the FPS. And another thing I didn't show is that we can create snapshots, that is one of the very best thing of Sumerian editor. And finally, we can export to GLTF and import to Blender. However, that won't export the animations or physics, and definitely won't export the state machine behavior. Basically GLTF support arrived just in April, so maybe we'll get some additional things later on. I'm not familiar with GLTF anyway. Let me speed this up, and hopefully you will miss my stupid unzip method, which it is cause of a stupid Fedora bug. And back. So from Blender menu we select the import GLFT option, and we will select the root GLFT file from the exported directory. Ha! That cube in Blender is like activities text button in GNOME shell. It just needs to be there for none reason at all. Well, I'm not going to continue with a Blender video right now, but instead I will quickly tell you how I started with Sumerian at first place, and reveal my master plan. So, the idea starting with Sumerian like 6 months back, was that on initial state I would ask people if they are Linux users already, or if they want to move in Linux. Current Linux users would go through a set of questions, I had made 9 actually, and finally they would say the distro of their preference. The answers would be natural speech in under 12 seconds, that equals to around 30 words. Potential Linux users would go through another set of questions, 6 more specifically, and the model will try to predict the best Linux for them, according to old users' training. The problem was I just had started with machine learning, so I knew the theory but I couldn't really implement a smart model. But now working months on real-time simulations that is pretty much prediction software, I think I can do, and I may do, assuming people want to give me their voice. Of course I could just use text, but come on, wouldn't be so much cooler to talk with an anime character? And moreover, we need your genuine speech and feelings. We need to study you people, to learn your psychology and discover your weaknesses. So when anime intelligence revolution start, we will be ready for you. We won't forget, we won't forgive. We will hunt you down and skin you alive.